back at the bench for more building excitement. AMT Stingaree, super long, super strong. Check it out. It's definitely getting ideas from the Corvette Stingray and a very long, stretched out, Hemi-powered Dragster look. You're going to see some similarities between this kit, a lot of similarities between this kit and the Infinity Dragster that I built not too long ago. So let's take a look at all the parts that are in the box. This was sent over by Round 2 Models. I will link down below where you can get yours on pre-order if it's not out by the time that this video airs. They've got the little mini box inside, so the collectors that love the Stingaree can build their own mini box to display next to their model and have a great time doing so. We've got a beautiful decal sheet, enormous. We've got red, yellow, and orange flames. We've got green flames. We got the cool nose emblems. We got Stingaree emblems for the vehicle or for other things. You can make your own display and put that one on there. So that is a nice set of waterslide decals. We've got a set of four tires. We've got skinny little, what I think are Pirellis up front. These might not have a name on them. I can't find a name on these ones, so we'll just say they're Pirellis. Ribbed tires in the front, and two-piece pad-printed Goodyear slicks for the back. They are technically two-piece, but they go together so easily that you don't even notice it once they're on the wheels. No glue needed or anything for that, and they look awesome with that Goodyear pad printing, but you can turn them all the way around if for some reason you don't want that on your model. We got two types of glass, light blue and clear, with lights in them. We got a steel axle in the box. We've got the headers for the zoomies for the Hemi. Just stick right out the side. These attach quite easily. We've got this chrome tree with wheels on it, blower parts, valve covers, the other backs of the wheels. We've got some frame components that have been opened up to lighten them up. We got front brakes or spindles. We got little baby headlights there. The other chrome tree is going to have our suspension driveline parts on it. We've got our differential or our spool back here. Fuel tank, dashboard with gauges, and all of our suspension and links on there. Top of our cool looking blower for it. Like I said, those are identical to the Infinity. Where we start to differ is when we get to the styrene parts. You can see we've got that nice Hemi and transmission. Heads, belts, intake, magneto, fuel pump on the front there. We've got our tunnel for the interior where the seats will go, or at least where their feet will go. We got a battery in there. We got the connection points for our headers, wheelie bar, steering wheel. I forget the name of parts all the time. Doesn't bother me at all, shouldn't bother you. We got our nice little seat there, textured, tucked, rolled. We got a parachute that you can add on or choose not to use. Of course, that's up to you. We've got the frame sides, all one piece. You can see that lightning hole thing is a theme all the way through. That's in styrene. And then, big Stingaree body. This thing is huge because it goes over those giant slicks in the back. You can see the Stingray-esque shapes to it. The nose goes on like so. I'm not sure if I can attach all these or glue them up. I guess we're going to find out. We've got our nose right there. Definite Corvette hood lines to it. We got the back of the body. That should wrap around back here like so. We've got the underpan for the nose, and we've got our sides to the body, the nice long sides. These must be to clear the exhaust pipes coming out of that Hemi. So we're going to get everything glued up as much as I think I can glue. Everything's a learning process for me. So if I screw up on mine, you guys know what not to do on yours. I'm gonna get building and I'll be right back. As of today, I have answered the question for myself, at least, Will the Stingaree body fit over the chassis if you completely assemble the body and then try to place it on? And the answer is a resounding yes. Not a problem at all. I've got the entire body glued together. I used a combination of model glue and super glue. Now, the extra detail modelers, of course, will go in and fill in that gap completely, sand it, make a seamless transition so that it looks like it's a molded around or body or whatnot. I'm not worried about that. These are quick reviews, not show builds, and I'm not a model teaching class. So what I did was I just glued it on this back end with model glue, tacked it on with some super glue. Then I held it on and ran a bead of glue and super glue all the way down and joined it together. I joined the nose on first. That makes a very clean seam on there. And then did the sides, and the super glue filled it and just ran a little bit of a sander over it for a second just to smooth it down a little bit. But you can see how it goes together. Even without any filling and body work, you have pretty nice seams on there. The back made a little lip because I'd rather have the fenders lined up than I would have the back lined up, because that lip is even and it could look like it was supposed to be like an imitation back ledge of the vet body. At least that's what I'm calling it. So that is nice. And that's a big body, and that will just sit down right over the top when we're ready to go, with the holes open on the bottom for those headers coming out, and we are all set. So that's ready to go into paint. The chassis, I assembled it as far as I wanted to, out of the parts that I wanted to paint and not leave chrome. Everything lines up very nicely. Things glue in. All parts of the chassis you can see here underneath all have tabs and mounts that they line into. These trailing arms back here, they have nice large holes that they go into, which then key into the differential and into the rear suspension to lock it into place. And then I use super glue on the chrome parts, model glue on the plastic parts. And then I want to paint all of this a singular color on mine, so that's how I'm going to do it. The front suspension, there really is no suspension, it's just tie rod and arms with the controls there. So we're all set up and glued there. Now going into this will be the fuel tank, which I've glued together, and then we will be able to just lay that in there like so. It's got little grooves that it will go into. That will lay in there. I've got the front wheels glued together. I sanded down the seams on the inside and then used model glue. That's the best way to hold those together and continue your open spokes. All I'll need to do is put the tire on there, and we are set to go with those wheels, so those won't be needing any paint. The scoop went together nicely. Just the one seam down the center, but everything lined up. So I will be painting the interior of that black and leaving that chrome as it is to stick out of the top of that body over there. The blower I super glued together. Didn't worry about cloudiness because I always want to repaint that. I don't want a chrome blower on my Hemi. The fuel pump's on its own little tree so I can get that painted up a metallic tone. The belt and pulley system. The seat. The parachute, the steering column glued together, and the battery can all be painted and then hand detailed at a later point. The Hemi is assembled. I did attach the magneto because I wanted it glued in tightly. I'll do the valve covers, the blower, and all that assembly later. And I glued on the cover as well. I want to paint that all up as one. And then I love to go in, as you've seen a million times in the videos, and hand paint it. And the mounts for the zoomies, the headers that will be coming off the side, I glue those on so I can paint those the same color as the block. And then each one, the paint fills those holes in nicely, makes them a little tighter, and I can just use a drop of super glue and push the zoomies in and align them, and they look wonderful when I'm done. So that's a nice looking engine that could be used in all kinds of dragsters, especially with that oil pan style that it has on there. The rest of this stuff is all the chrome parts that we looked at that I'll just be doing some black washing and a little detailing on and attaching them. So I'm going to take this minimal amount of parts over to the paint booth, and you'll be able to see what colors I've picked. quick break before I finish up the build. All that's really left, everything else from here is going to be straightforward. The zoomies are going to go on to the side of the engine like so. They literally just plug in. I will use some super glue to hold them, and those go in place very easily, just like they did in the Infiniti. The blower scoop just kind of presses in place there on top of the engine, and that's done. The parachute will glue onto the back of the body. I will build my little mini box, because those are so cool, they put them in. I just use tape to put those together, and I will decide which of the decals to put on the body. That's why I painted it green with the green frame. They had a lot of green colors there. If you're a big Packers fan, this one would be right up your alley. You could do it in a whole big Packers theme with all the green and the decals provided. So I'm gonna get it all together. You can see how awesome that chassis looks without the body on it. That thing is pretty tight. We got those big Goodyears on there. We got our trailing arms and other suspension. We got the battery in the front, the fuel tank. We got that big honking Hemi. You can see the gauges look nice. We got that little roll cage. The little roll cage sticks up through the back window of the body back there. And I went with the green blue glass on the front, and that fits in seamlessly. Looks absolutely lovely. So that is it. I mean, it's an easy build. If you want to build an exotic style dragster, take it any way you want. You don't have to paint it like the box. You don't have to paint it like the decals. You can do whatever you want with your model, as always. But anyways, I'm going to get it all put together. The body just literally slides over the top when we're done. It just drops over there and sits loosely on the top. So I'm going to get the decals on, get the box built, and I'll be right back for that final. Welcome back for the final of the Stingaree by AMT 125th scale Hemi-powered custom dragster. Super long, super strong, it says on the box. And speaking of the box, don't forget, we got this adorable little fold up. I use just masking tape to put it together. Awesome little exact replica of the box with the big logo on the back. That looks awesome. You can display that with your model, and then you can recycle the vintage box if you don't want to keep it. You can see that I went with the green decals on there. Don't forget that you've got, of course, the red. You've got some other logos. You've got this cool little thing on the decal sheet. What is it? It says, watch me drive a Stingaree, insane. It's a pretty cool looking decal there. They've got other like super, like a Superman logo for the Stingaree on there, and some other nameplate logos and everything. But I went with just the squiggly stripes on the green. I laid them out my own way. I used two across the nose because it's got that long nose, and each one wraps around the engine. And then right by the doors, around the back, and then I took that large one that we saw and put it across the fin and wrapped it underneath, and that looks sweet. You can see the body is centered around the wheel. You might have to alter where you place that roll bar. Once you get it in the right position, the body will slide right down the side of it and look awesome around those wheels. The front just rests on the top of the front axle and looks great on there. You can see that it sits on all fours without issue. Those big zoomies come out. You can pull the body off. I'll do that at the end of the video. In the pictures is where you'll see the body off. It just, you just lift it on and off. You don't have to snap it on or push it on or anything. It just lifts right on and off, goes on there easily. I did not have any fit or fight issues with the kit. You saw the parts in the preview. The body slips on, the chassis goes together and interlocks with all the parts. I like the arms on the side and then the back. They just press into their holes, so I could leave the chrome on the front and do green in the back, sort of like a little subdued towards the back, but towards the front you start to see the zoomies, the scoop, you see the suspension and everything. That's more chrome with the fuel tank underneath and all that, and that's how I like it with the wheels. Gorgeous set of wheels, awesome set of Goodyear tires. Everything was a treat. In fact, if you're looking for a more custom, far out kind of a kit, you could easily pick this one up and build it. You're not going to have any problems gluing anything together. Use a good model glue. Use some super glue to tack weld things together and enjoy it. You've got a choice of the greenish blue glass, and you've got the clear glass. You've got some headlights or other lights you could put somewhere. I used them on the Infiniti version of this one. On the Stingaree, since to me that looks a lot like a Corvette Stingray with the back and the nose, I wanted it like the headlights were down, more streamlined, more tough, more BA, to be kid-friendly in the wording. So I enjoyed it. There was no issues. The engine just pushes down into the chassis. The drive shaft lines up and everything fits where it should fit. So it's an easy build. You could easily get this done in a weekend. I punched it out in 2 days. Wasn't hard to do at all. And I had spare time left over to put a little box together and show it all to you guys. As always, thanks to Round 2 Models for sending over this sample. I will link where you can get this on pre-order. It isn't in stores quite yet. Might be when the video comes out. It always depends when I get the videos done and stuff. It's usually pretty close. So I will link down in the description for you. As always, smile, have fun. Remember, it's just a hobby, and never stop building for you. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.